UP Studios presents Pugland 2, King Ben's Revenge. Prologue, a new playdate. It had been a few weeks since Jet and Zeke's extraordinary adventure in Pugland. The two friends had returned to their ordinary lives, but the memories of their time in the magical world still lingered in their minds. One sunny afternoon, Jet and Zeke were having another playdate at Zeke's house. They sat on the floor, engrossed in a Nintendo game, their laughter filling the room as they navigated virtual worlds together. As they played, Jet couldn't help but feel a sense of nostalgia for the pugs and creatures they had met, the adventures they had shared, and the bonds they had formed in Pugland. Finally, Jet couldn't contain his excitement any longer. He turned to Zeke and said, "You know what, Zeke? I've been thinking. We're going back to Pugland, right?" Zeke grinned, his eyes lighting up with enthusiasm. "Definitely." Their ordinary playdate had ignited a spark of adventure in their hearts once more. Little did they know that their return to Pugland would bring even more extraordinary experiences and new adventures. Chapter 1, The Other Friend. Jet and Zeke stood eagerly at the threshold of Zeke's bedroom, the room itself pulsating with a mysterious energy. Between them, cradled carefully in Zeke's hands, was a rare Mario figure, its intricate details shimmering under the soft glow of the room's ambient light. This wasn't just any collectible, it was the key to their extraordinary adventures in Pugland. Their intention was clear: activate the figure and revisit the magical realm that had captivated their imaginations. As Zeke poised the Mario figure for what they hoped would be another journey through the portal, the doorbell's chime reverberated through the house, shattering their focused anticipation. "I'll get it," Zeke exclaimed, setting the Mario figure down reluctantly and pivoting toward the entrance. Upon opening the door, Zeke's eyes widened in astonishment. "Jack," he greeted, a mix of surprise and delight coloring his voice. "Hey, Zeke. Hope I'm not interrupting anything," Jack replied, stepping inside with a casual grin. As Zeke led Jack into the living room, Jet discreetly concealed the Mario figure, sensing the need to explain their secretive endeavor. "You're just in time," Jet remarked, attempting to steer the conversation toward their recent adventures. Intrigued by their cryptic demeanor, Jack's curiosity piqued. "What's going on?" he inquired, his eyes darting between Jet and Zeke. Seizing the moment, Jet began to recount their unbelievable journey to Pugland, carefully navigating the delicate balance between truth and fantasy. He detailed their encounters with talking pugs, battles against the nefarious King Ben, and the pivotal role the Mario figure played in their escapades. As Jack listened intently, a skeptical expression clouded his features. "You expect me to believe that?" he questioned, raising an eyebrow in disbelief. Determined to validate their claims, Zeke locked eyes with Jack, his resolve unwavering. "It's all true, Jack. And we'll prove it to you," he declared, setting the stage for a quest that would once again blur the lines between reality and the enchanting world of Pugland. The stage is set for an adventure filled with challenges, discovery, and the undeniable allure of a magical realm awaiting exploration. Chapter 2, Disenchanted Hopes. With determined strides, Jet, Zeke, and Jack made their way to Zeke's room, the atmosphere thick with anticipation and skepticism. The dim lighting cast elongated shadows across the room, creating an ambience that heightened the sense of mystery surrounding the rare Mario figure resting on Zeke's desk. "Here it is," Zeke murmured, picking up the figure with reverence. His fingers delicately traced its contours, hoping to unlock the portal to Pugland once more. Jet and Zeke exchanged a glance, nodding in silent agreement before touching the Mario figure in unison. A hushed silence enveloped the room as they waited with bated breath, expecting the familiar shimmering portal to materialize before their eyes. Seconds felt like an eternity, but to their dismay, nothing happened. The room remained unchanged, devoid of any magical gateway or fantastical creatures welcoming them back to Pugland. Jack, maintaining his composed demeanor, simply shrugged. "See, I knew it wasn't real," he remarked casually, his earlier skepticism validated. Jet and Zeke's faces flushed with disbelief and confusion, their confidence shattered. "But it was real. We swear," Jet protested, struggling to comprehend the failed attempt. Ignoring their shocked expressions, Jack leaned against the doorframe, his curiosity piqued. "All right, why did you guys go through all of this? What's the real story behind the Mario figure?" Caught off guard and still reeling from the unsuccessful attempt, Jet and Zeke exchanged glances. Grappling with the best way to articulate their extraordinary experiences without the tangible proof they had hoped to provide. After a moment of hesitation, Zeke finally spoke, "We wanted to share something incredible with you, Jack. To prove that the adventures we described were more than just stories." Jack, sensing their genuine disappointment, softened his tone. "Look, I appreciate the effort, but sometimes stories are meant to be enjoyed for what they are, stories." While Jack attempted to console them, Jet and Zeke remained fixated on the Mario figure, its dormant state casting a shadow over their once unwavering belief in the magical realm of Pugland. Reluctantly, they shifted their focus back to their playdate, but the air of disappointment lingered, casting a pall over the room. The Mario figure, once a symbol of adventure and possibility, now stood as a silent testament to the uncertainty and complexities of belief. Leaving Jet and Zeke questioning the very fabric of their extraordinary experiences. Chapter 3, Unexpected Detours Determined to shake off the lingering disappointment of their failed attempt to reopen the portal, Jet, Zeke, and Jack redirected their focus to their playdate. The trio delved into a series of engaging activities, aiming to create new memories and strengthen their bond. First on the agenda was a spirited round of video games, with each player showcasing their skills and sharing playful banter. Laughter echoed throughout the room as they competed in friendly competitions, momentarily immersing themselves in virtual worlds devoid of magical realms and talking pugs. After a series of exhilarating matches, Zeke proposed a change of scenery. "How about we go biking?" he suggested, sensing the need for a refreshing outdoor adventure. Jet and Jack eagerly agreed, and the trio made their way to the garage, retrieving their bikes and helmets in anticipation of their journey. With the sun casting a warm glow upon them, they embarked on a leisurely ride through familiar streets, each turn revealing new sights and experiences. As they pedaled along, Jet's attention was captivated by a particularly adorable pug lounging outside a nice house. "Look at that pug," he exclaimed, momentarily distracted by its playful antics and endearing appearance. Zeke chuckled, "You have a soft spot for pugs, don't you?" he remarked, recalling their adventures in Pugland. Before they could further indulge in their admiration for the delightful creature, a sudden flash of red light illuminated the horizon, casting a surreal glow that halted them in their tracks. A portal materialized before them, its shimmering surface eerily reminiscent of the gateway to Pugland. Jet and Zeke exchanged knowing glances, recognizing the unmistakable signs of their magical realm. However, Jack, wide-eyed and bewildered, could only muster a stunned response. "What the heck is that?" he exclaimed, his voice tinged with disbelief and awe. The portal's appearance shattered the mundane reality they had grown accustomed to, reigniting the possibility of another journey to Pugland. With uncertainty and excitement intertwining, the trio stood on the brink of a new adventure, poised to confront the mysteries and challenges that awaited them beyond the shimmering threshold. Chapter 4, Return to Pugland. As the pulsating red portal loomed before them, Jet, Zeke, and Jack hesitated momentarily, captivated by its mesmerizing allure. Jack's apprehensive expression betrayed his inner turmoil, his skepticism warring with the allure of the unknown. "I don't know about this, guys," Jack murmured, uncertainty clouding his features. "It seems risky." Jet and Zeke exchanged a determined glance, understanding Jack's reservations but also recognizing the opportunity that lay before them. "Trust us," Zeke urged, extending a reassuring hand towards his friend. "We've been through this before." With a hesitant nod, Jack took a deep breath, steeling himself for the impending journey. "All right, let's do it," he conceded, placing his trust in Jet and Zeke's conviction. As they crossed the threshold of the portal, a whirlwind of sensations enveloped them. They were catapulted through a tunnel of swirling red light, the world around them distorting and shifting as they hurtled toward their unknown destination. Moments later, they were unceremoniously deposited onto the cold, hard ground of a grand throne room, its opulent decor and regal ambience signaling their return to Pugland. Dusting themselves off, Jet and Zeke's eyes darted around the room before settling on the figure seated upon the ornate throne. It was Argo, their trusted ally and friend, his wise eyes meeting theirs with a mixture of relief and joy. Without hesitation, Jet and Zeke rushed forward, enveloping Argo in a heartfelt embrace, their reunion transcending words. "Argo! We've missed you," Jet exclaimed, overcome with emotion. Pulling away slightly, Argo returned their embrace, his voice tinged with warmth and gratitude. "It's good to see you both. Pugland has missed you." As they settled into a more relaxed stance, Argo's demeanor grew serious, recounting the events that transpired in their absence. With King Ben's defeat, Pugland faced a period of uncertainty. "The Order of the Pug rallied together, and with their support, I reclaimed my rightful place as king. The realm is slowly healing, but challenges remain." Jet and Zeke listened intently, absorbing Argo's words and preparing themselves for the new adventures and responsibilities that awaited them in Pugland. With Argo's guidance and their unwavering determination, they were ready to embark on another chapter in their extraordinary journey. United in their quest to ensure the realm's continued prosperity and peace. Chapter 5, The Gathering of the Order. As Jet, Zeke, Jack, and Argo stood in the Grand Throne Room, a stirring in the air heralded the arrival of familiar figures. The doors creaked open, and members of the Order of the Pug marched in with purposeful strides. The room filled with a chorus of excited barks and joyful expressions as the pug spotted Jet and Zeke. "Jet! Zeke!" exclaimed Kit, the energetic pug with a penchant for adventure, bounding towards them with unbridled enthusiasm. Max and Dave, the stalwart members of the Order, joined the welcoming party, their tails wagging in sync. "It's good to have you back," Max barked, while Dave added a playful spin to his greeting. Amidst the joyful reunion, Kit couldn't contain her curiosity. "Tell us everything. What happened? And who's this?" she asked, glancing at Jack, who stood amidst the group, still trying to comprehend the fantastical scene unfolding before him. Jet and Zeke began recounting their journey, from meeting with Jack to their unexpected return to Pugland to the joyous reunion with Argo. As they shared their experiences, the pugs listened attentively, interjecting with barks of approval and gasps of surprise. Once the tales were told, Kit spoke up, her eyes gleaming with determination. "While you were away, we've been working hard to build a new Puglandé realm free from the tyranny of bulldogs. It's a place where pugs and other creatures live in harmony." Max added, "but we've received troubling information. The remnants of King Ben's forces are hiding, planning something big. We need your help to find them before they strike." Jet and Zeke exchanged determined glances, understanding the gravity of the situation. "We're here to help," Zeke declared, his commitment unwavering. With a solemn nod, Dave informed them, "We believe the bulldogs are hiding in the Shrouded Canyons. It's a dangerous and mysterious place, but we must venture there to ensure Pugland's safety." As the group prepared for their next mission, Argo spoke, "Jet, Zeke, you have a unique connection to Pugland. Your return signifies hope and strength for our realm. Together, we will face whatever challenges lie ahead." With the Order of the Pug united, the group set forth on a new adventure, the fate of Pugland hanging in the balance. The Shrouded Canyons awaited, harboring secrets and potential dangers that would test the bonds of friendship and the resilience of their newfound alliance. Chapter 6, Return to the Order's Base. With the echoes of their reunion still resonating, Kit, the energetic pug, bounded forward with infectious enthusiasm. "You all just got here, so let's go back to the Order's base. We can talk about the mission, celebrate your return, and get to know Jack." The proposition was met with nods of agreement, and the group made their way back through the enchanted halls of the throne room, excitement palpable in the air. Arriving at the Order's base, a cozy den adorned with maps, scrolls, and various artifacts, the pugs led Jet, Zeke, Jack, and Argo to a gathering area. The atmosphere buzzed with a lively energy as they settled into a circle, ready to discuss the impending mission and revel in the camaraderie that bound them together. Kit, perched on a small cushion, took charge. "Okay, first things first. We need a plan for the Shrouded Canyons. Dave, what's the latest intel on the Bulldogs' activities?" Dave, the seasoned member of the Order, unrolled a map, his paw tracing the jagged lines of the Shrouded Canyons. "Reports indicate increased bulldog activity in this region. We suspect they're gathering for something significant, but the exact details remain elusive." As the discussion unfolded, Jack listened intently, his initial bewilderment giving way to a newfound curiosity about Pugland and its unique challenges. Meanwhile, Kit took a moment to turn the conversation toward a lighter note. "Now, let's talk about our guests. Jack, Tell us a bit about yourself, she prompted, her eyes sparkling with curiosity. Jack, though initially reserved, began sharing anecdotes and interests, gradually becoming more comfortable in the company of these extraordinary pugs and their friends. As the discussions ebbed and flowed, laughter and camaraderie filled the air. The pugs shared tales of their adventures, exchanged playful banter, and reveled in the warmth of newfound friendships. Argo, observing the scene with a wise and contented gaze, knew that their return had not only brought hope to Pugland but had also rekindled the spirit of unity within the order. As the evening unfolded, the den echoed with the joyous sounds of celebration, setting the stage for the challenges and triumphs that awaited them in the mysterious Shrouded Canyons. Chapter 7, Outfitting for the Quest. After the lively discussion and celebration in the gathering area, Kit, Max, Dave and Argo led Jet, Zeke, and Jack to a newly added armory room within the Order's base. The room was adorned with an array of weapons, armor, and magical artifacts. Kit, being the fashion-forward pug, couldn't resist the opportunity to transform their appearances for the quest ahead. "We've prepared special outfits for you," she announced, her eyes gleaming with excitement. Zeke, known for his adventurous spirit, was the first to step forward. The pugs had crafted a set of leather armor adorned with intricate green patterns. A matching hood and cape completed the ensemble, giving Zeke a distinctly heroic look. Jet's outfit featured a sleek combination of yellow and silver, symbolizing the radiance of the sun. His cloak billowed with an ethereal quality, echoing the magical essence of Pugland. As for Jack, they tailored an ensemble that seamlessly blended with the Group A versatile outfit reflecting the colors of nature, allowing him to move freely and adapt to the challenges of the Shrouded Canyons. With the transformations complete, the group marveled at their new appearances. "You look like true adventurers now," Kit exclaimed, her tail wagging with satisfaction. Before they could embark on their quest, the pugs gathered the group once more. "We've used a rare spell that can only be cast once every week to open a portal and bring you back to Pugland. It will take a while to get back if Ben somehow creates a portal. So make the most of your time here and help us with the quest," Max explained. Jet, Zeke, and Jack expressed their gratitude for the pugs' efforts, understanding the sacrifice made to ensure their return. With outfits adorned and the portal spell in place, the group headed towards the shimmering gateway that would transport them to the mysterious Shrouded Canyons. The fate of Pugland hung in the balance, and the unity of the Order, strengthened by their newfound allies, promised to face the challenges ahead with courage and determination. As they epped through the portal, the familiar sensation of being transported through magical realms enveloped them once more, marking the beginning of their next extraordinary adventure. Chapter 8, Perils in the Misty Shrouded Canyons. As the group arrived in the Misty Shrouded Canyons through the magical portal, the atmosphere was thick with an otherworldly mist. Jack, feeling disoriented, voiced his discomfort. "Guys, I feel like I'm gonna puke," he confessed, his face pale from the disorienting journey. "Take a deep breath, Jack. You'll get used to it," reassured Jet, placing a supportive hand on his friend's shoulder. Max, leading the way through the mysterious landscape, issued a warning. "Be careful. This is a very dangerous place. The mist can conceal hidden dangers." They began scouring the rocky terrain, searching for any signs of the elusive bulldogs. The mist played tricks on their senses, creating an eerie atmosphere that heightened their awareness. As they ventured deeper, the group stumbled upon an odd cave. Strange noises emanated from within, prompting them to investigate cautiously. "Could this be a hiding spot for the bulldogs?" whispered Zeke, glancing around with a mix of curiosity and trepidation. Max, ever vigilant, cautioned them, "Stay on your guard. Anything could be lurking in there." As they inched closer to the cave entrance, a sudden movement caught their attention. Without warning, a massive, 3-foot-tall spider emerged from the shadows, its multiple eyes gleaming with malevolence. Startled, the group leaped into action, brandishing their newly acquired weapons. The misty canyons echoed with the clash of steel against the arachnid foe as they fought for survival. Jack, overcoming his initial nausea, joined the fray, determined to prove his mettle in this unexpected battle. The spider, relentless and cunning, tested their resolve. With teamwork and strategic maneuvers, they managed to fend off the creature, sending it scuttling back into the depths of the cave. "What was that?" Zeke yelled. "I thought y'all AHD spiders in your world?" Argo replied, "Yeah, but they're not 3 feet tall," Zeke yelled back. Breathing heavily, the group gathered their composure. Max spoke with a stern expression, "This is just the beginning. The Shrouded Canyons are full of surprises. Stay focused, and be prepared for anything." As they delved deeper into the misty expanse, the challenge ahead loomed larger than ever. The search for the elusive bulldogs continued, with each step revealing more mysteries and dangers hidden within the enigmatic Shrouded Canyons. Chapter 9, The Whispering Abyss. The group pressed further into the misty Shrouded Canyons, the air thick with tension. Suddenly, an intense vibration resonated through the rocky terrain, causing the very ground beneath their feet to quake. Panic set in as the canyon walls seemed to close in, creating a claustrophobic atmosphere. "This isn't normal," muttered Zeke, his eyes scanning the surroundings for the source of the disturbance. As they navigated through the shifting landscape, an abyss-like chasm suddenly materialized before them. Whispers echoed from its depths, their unsettling words reverberating through the canyon. It was as if the very essence of Pugland was communicating, a cryptic message shrouded in mystery. "We need to be cautious," warned Argo, his eyes reflecting concern. "The Shrouded Canyons hold ancient secrets that even I may not fully understand." Tensions heightened as the group deliberated their next move. The chasm seemed both an obstacle and an opportunity, its depths concealing unknown dangers and potential revelations. Just as they contemplated their options, distant voices echoed through the mist. Hope surged within them, and they hastened toward the source of the sounds. Cresting a rocky ridge, they beheld a camp nestled in a hidden alcove, camp occupied by none other than the elusive bulldogs. Excitement rippled through the group as they strategized their approach. Instead of an immediate confrontation, they decided to conceal themselves and eavesdrop on the bulldogs' conversation. The misty veil provided a perfect cover for their reconnaissance. "We found them," whispered Kit, her eyes gleaming with determination. With newfound resolve, the group stealthily positioned themselves to listen in on the bulldogs' discussions. The misty Shrouded Canyons had yielded both peril and promise, and as they awaited the unfolding dialogue, the echoes of their surroundings heralded the beginning of a decisive chapter in their quest. Chapter 10, Secrets in the Mist. Hidden amidst the shadows of the misty Shrouded Canyons, the group listened intently to the bulldogs' casual chatter. The fog provided cover as the bulldogs exchanged stories, unaware of the eavesdroppers. "So, what do you think about King Ben's plans?" one bulldog asked, their gruff voice carrying through the mist. A hushed silence fell over the group as they strained to catch every word. Another bulldog responded, "About stealing the Yulimacords?" Argo's gasp cut through the air, resonating so loudly that the bulldog's ears perked up in alarm. Sensing danger, they readied themselves for an unexpected threat. A skirmish erupted as Argo's exclamation exposed their hidden presence. Blades clashed, and spells were cast, creating a chaotic tableau in the misty canyons. Amidst the melee, Argo urgently called to the others, "This isn't just about the fate of Pugland. If he's going after the Yulimacords, it's way worse." The revelation hung in the air, ominous and foreboding. The Yulimacords, ancient artifacts of immense power, held the potential to unleash forces beyond imagination. As the group grappled with the unfolding danger,